Good morning, all my beautiful patrons. Today we're going to be doing our fall wreath. So these are the supplies that I have chosen. So what you're going to need is whatever worsted weight yarn you're going to be using. I chose this Red Heart Super Saver in the color gold because it matched my sign really well. And you're going to need a 5.5 millimeter crochet hook. You're going to need whatever sort of decoration that you are choosing. I chose a sign from the Dollar Tree. My wreath form is also from the Dollar Tree, so you're going to need whatever type of wreath form that you chose. And whatever decorations that you have chosen. So for me, I wanted my sign to be the focal point, and then I'm just going to use these fall-colored flowers. I have two of each color that I'm just going to use to kind of accent around the sign. I wish I had some sunflowers on hand, but I don't. So I'm just going to go ahead and use the ones that I already have on hand. And of course, like I said, you're going to need your wreath form. So wreath forms come in a variety of different styles and sizes. So I'm going to give you the general directions and kind of show you how I have done the cover for my wreath form, which is done out of crochet. But you'll be able to adapt this to any size wreath form that you have. So if you have one smaller than this or larger than this, you'll still be able to use the same concept for whatever wreath form that you have. And that's the beauty about this particular type of project, is because you can use it for a variety of different sizes and still be able to use the same concept. So aside from your general supplies, you're going to need your scissors. You're also going to need your yarn needle, which I forgot to bring out. So you're also going to need your glue gun and your glue sticks. I'm also going to be using some little gems. I have just three of them here, and they are just out of one of these big tubs that you find at Hobby Lobby. I bought this forever ago, that's why it's all boogered up. But I think I bought it on clearance. It's normally $15.99, at least then it was. I think I paid like $5 for it or something, but it's a pound of gems. So I just have some that match my sign. Because my sign has a hanger on it, so you're supposed to be able to hang it up. So I want to cover up those holes, and I'm going to use these gems for that.
Like I said, whatever, you know, supplies that you're going to need, you know, your general notions. So I went ahead and I have went ahead and did my cover for my wreath form, and I'll go ahead and do a sample piece. So I have some scrap yarn here that's going to show you how I did this, but I went ahead and did mine, and what I did was I measured so I measured the distance around, the circumference around my wreath form. I hope that I'm in frame. And then the entire length of the wreath form. Now remember that crochet does stretch, so you can probably do a little bit less than what the wreath form length is, but you don't want it to stretch so much that you can see the wreath form itself. So this is what mine looks like. It's just a really long rectangle. I did choose a different color than what I had originally planned. I originally planned on using this one, which is Red Hard Fall. Beautiful fall colors, one of my favorite colorways from Red Heart. But it did not go well with my sign, so I went ahead and went with the Red Heart Gold, which that's what this color is. It's called Gold. And for my particular wreath form, which I got at Dollar Tree, It's a pretty standard size that they have at Dollar Tree. It says on the tag, because I still have the tag on it, it says a 14-inch wreath form. So for mine, mine was 20 stitches in width, and that's also 6 inches. And then I had 130 rows long, and that was also 42 inches. So I went ahead and counted it out and measured it for you so you would know. So 20 stitches wide, which equals 6 inches, and 135 rows long, which was 42 inches. So I don't know if that's useful to anybody, but I thought I would go ahead and do it anyway. So to start with, we're going to start working on our cover. So like I've said, I went ahead and worked up mine. And so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to kind of clean off my area here a little bit. And you're going to need your wreath form for the beginning here because you're going to need to measure it. So what I did is really simple. I just chained until I had to choose a scrap piece of yarn that had a huge knot in it. I chained until my chain fit loosely around my wreath form. So, sorry about that. So I already know that mine was 20, so I just chained until I was able to wrap it around my wreath form loosely. You don't want it too loose, but you do want the two ends just to meet because we are going to need to seam this up, and we're going to do that with a single crochet. So you just want it to, I hope that I'm in frame. Sorry, I'm using my new camera, and this is the first time I've filmed a tutorial with it, so I just want to make sure that everything's in frame and everything. So you're just going to want it to chain until it's loosely around your wreath form. So once you've done that, you're going to start working on the rectangle. So, and mine is all single crochet, so it may take you a little bit to work your panel, and I'm going to chain one more because I want to keep that number when I'm working my first single crochet, and I'm going to be working in the back loop. So you're just going to go in all the back loops with a single crochet. And working in the back loop just makes a nicer edge to be able to seam it with. And it just looks, you know, nicer in the long run. And since we're going to be seaming these two ends together, it's a lot easier when you have a really nice edge to be able to do that. It minimizes the gappiness, is why I do that. So, and once you start working in the back loop, it becomes a lot faster. I know when I first was learning how to do it, it felt like it took me forever. So, but now it's, you know, secondhand. I don't have to really even think about it. I just automatically do it. Okay, so this is my last stitch. So, basically what you're going to do is you're just going to do chain one, and you're going to put one single crochet in every stitch across and repeat until you're to the length that you need to be. I don't chain. I don't use any chains or anything. I don't like the way they look. They leave it really gappy, and I have found that if I just go do a chain one, which is just going to get me a little higher, and I forget, I just pretend that that's not even there, and then I go straight in with whatever stitch that I'm using, it just looks a lot neater, and you don't have those gaps that you would in another, if you were to chain. So that gives you a nice neat edge, just like we have here. If I was to use chains here, you would have holes, and I really don't like the look of that, so that's the reason why I do it this way. You will never see me use a chain two or three, depending on whatever stitch I'm using, just simply because I don't like holey fabric, so I like my fabric to be very consistent all the way through. So like I said, we're just going to be putting one single crochet in every stitch. These are really, really simple, but they look really nice when you're done with them. And I love projects like that, that look like you've spent a lot of time on it, but you really haven't. And I always, with my projects, I always try to make it budget friendly. And this is a great way to be able to make a beautiful wreath and not spend a whole lot of money on it. Really, the most that you're spending is the cost of your yarn. So that was my last stitch. So you're just going to repeat that until your piece is as long as you need it to be. So I'm going to move on to how we're going to do the wreath once you get your panel finished. So here's my panel, and it's the length that I need it to be, so I'm going to put it together. I can move this now. So I'm just going to put the two ends together. Sorry about that. I don't know what the heck that was. And what I'm doing is I'm just pulling my loop through the other end of the panel. That way we can work the panels together. And we're just going to single crochet them just like you normally would when you're single crocheting anything. Sorry, I hope that I'm in frame. So I'm just going to go ahead and single crochet this. You could slip stitch it if you want. That would be perfectly fine too. But it's going to be on the inside, so you're not going to really see it. You could sew it, but I hate sewing, so... Sorry if you can hear that wind blowing. It's blowing really hard today. It's actually dramatically cooler today than it has been, so. Right, and here's my last stitch. And then you'll just chain one, and we're going to turn that right side out, and see, you have a nice, nice seam there. You really won't be able to notice it. So this is where we're going to start crocheting over our, or attaching this over our frame. So I'm just going to pull out a long loop. and then I'm just going to stretch this over top of our frame. So you want it about halfway over the entire, so you have it folded over to where you can have the two ends touching. And that's why you want it to be loosely, you want your beginning chain to fit loosely over your frame, because we're going to single crochet this all together. Now, this is where you can kind of personalize it. You can do it like I do and seam it on the inside, or you can do it to where your seam's on the outside and you will be able to do a decorative edging if you would like. That's totally up to you. But for me, I'm just going to seam it where the seam's on the inside. And we're just going to single crochet it together. And I hope that I'm able to get this into frame, because it is a little bit. And your tail heel here, just tuck inside. So you just want to bring your loop to the front, just like we did before. That way you can work both sides. And I'm just going to chain one. Sorry, this is a little fiddly trying to get it in camera. So I hope that you're able to see that. Yeah. So we're just going to single crochet those two edges together just like we did on the end. And you just kind of want to put your stitches evenly with the rows as best as you can. There's no real perfect way. And as long as you've made your beginning chain long enough, you'll have a little wiggle room to stretch it out, because this can be a little fiddly when you're trying to crochet this shut. It probably would be easier if you did the seam on the outside, but I kind of want my seam to be a little bit hidden on the inside because my sign's so big. But if you're doing like a sunflower theme like I am, it would be really pretty to do like a shell pico edge that kind of looks like sunflower petals. That would have been really beautiful if I had thought of it earlier. So I'm just going to go ahead and seam all the way around my edges, and then I will meet up with you when I am done. So just single crochet the two pieces together, and by the time you're done, your panel will be completely sealed. So I will meet up back up with you when I am finished.
Okay,
with mine.
So I finished seaming all mine together. So to end it off, I'm just going to slip stitch into that beginning stitch. And then yarn over and pull it through, and I'm just going to cut my yarn, pull that real tight, and then I went in and got my yarn needle, and then I'm just going to thread this through to hide my tail. I'm sure you guys all know how to do that.
pulled my end out. And then I'm just going to snip off whatever's left. And as you can see, it kind of turned up a little bit as I was crocheting it. So you just twist it around to where it lays nice and flat. Okay, now that you've got your cover situated to where you want it to be, you want to get your sign that you're going to be using. Of course, you know, when you're buying your sign, you don't have to get one as large as I did. But my Dollar Tree didn't have a whole lot of choice at this time. So, and I love sunflowers, so I was really drawn to this one. And I know it's almost the size of my wreath, but I'm okay with that. I think I'm going to off-center it a little bit. But before I get into that, you want to plug in your hot glue gun, which I should have already done, but I forgot. And since my sign, well, most signs will have some sort of string, and I want to cover up those holes, I just have these little gems that I'm going to be using just to cover up those little holes. And to make it not look so funny, I have clusters of three. So I'm going to do that real quick as soon as my... I'm sorry about all the noises. That's an airplane. It just seems to be very noisy today. But as soon as my hot glue gun heats up, I'm going to go ahead and position these and glue them on just, you know, to cover up that hole, just kind of like that. And you can also take your signs and decorate them if you want. You could add glitter to them. Dollar Tree just had a whole selection of glitter glue, which would be really nice. I might do that after my sign's done. Just go over the leaves with the yellow just to give it a little pop of color, or a little pop of sparkle, I mean. So that's always an idea. And, you know, of course, when you go to do, you know, pick your stuff, yours is going to be different than mine. So you just go ahead and choose whatever you like, whatever signs you like, whatever decorations, you know, all of that. And it all is just basically the same concept, no matter what you're doing. So, okay, so my glue gun is warmed up. So I'm just going to put a little dab of glue on each one of these gems, starting with the one that's going to go over the hole. And these are just those little plastic gems. You can pretty much find them at any craft store. I think Walmart probably even carries them. I got a big bag of them, or a big container of them, on clearance one time, and it never runs out. But it's just a little added touch, like I said, to cover up those holes. So just like that. And of course, this is totally a non-necessary step. If you don't want to do it, you don't have to. So you want to figure out where your sign is going to sit. I'm going to have mine a little off-center, sort of like that, and then you're just going to glue your sign down. So however you decide to glue your sign down, go ahead and do that. I'm going to start with one side and then move over to the other side. And you'll want to push down on it because you want that glue to seep into all the little crevices of the yarn. And you'll be able to feel when it cools off because I can feel it through the sign that it's still warm. And of course you can use whatever glue that you have on hand. I just have hot glue on hand, so of course, you want to try not to get it everywhere, which I always do. It's a little harder to pick off of yarn than it is a normal surface. And then you can just go around the edges that you didn't get and put a little hot glue in those areas. Okay, so once you're sure that your sign is going to stay, then you're just going to choose your decorations, whatever you have chosen, and you're going to put those on. So, hopefully I'm still in frame. So I have chosen flowers for mine. And I'm going to put them sort of kitty corner from each other. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave this long stem on it, the one that you just pull off when you pull it off the stem, and I'm just going to put some hot glue on that, and I'm going to poke it right into the crochet where I, that way it pokes all the way through and it's kind of, you know, sitting in there securely. I cannot talk today. It's driving me crazy. Then you'll just do the same thing with your other flowers or whatever it is that you have chose. And I'm just going to turn my wreath around and I'm going to place my second set. So I have two of each color that I'm going to be placing. I'm going to do it the same way. Just poke it right into the crochet fabric. You'll probably need to hold it there for just a few seconds until it starts to harden. And there is your sign. I think it's really gorgeous. So the last step is just to apply the hanger. I use crochet hangers for all of mine. So I just attach some yarn in the back. So you want to make sure that you get your exact placing for it to where your sign's going to hang properly, because you don't want it to hang crooked. And then you're just going to attach your yarn. So I leave a little bit of a longer tail when I'm doing this because I like to knot my two ends together just to make it a little bit more secure. So how I do mine is I do mine really short because we have a lot of wind here. And I find that if I make a larger loop to hang on my door hanger, it flies off. So mine is always fairly short. When I make them, and I just attach it with a slip knot right there. And then what I like to do is I like to pick it up from that spot and just see if it's going to hang right. Because you want your wreath to be straight. You don't want it to be all crooked or anything. So then you're just going to chain. So for mine, I only did 7, but like I said, mine needs to be a little bit tighter because where we live is so windy, and crochet stretches quite a bit. So you're just going to attach that back at the same spot with a slip knot. And then you're just going to fasten off. And like I said, I like to cut my strings a little bit longer because I will go ahead and tie this in a knot. Just to give it a little added security. You could probably, I don't know if they make them or not, but I'm sure they have some sort of wreath hangers that you could attach in some way or another, but I find that this works perfectly fine. And then what I do is I just take my tails and hide it on the inside of the wreath, the crochet portion. So I just hide it like I normally would. So there is our finished wreath. I hope you guys liked this. They're super simple and really fun to make, so stay tuned. I will be having different wreaths for every holiday up until here, from now until Christmas. So, and then probably every holiday after that, so, because I really like making them, and I would love to have one for every holiday and season for my home anyway. So like I said, I hope that you guys like it and have a great day.